Hello there, my name is Alaydriem, and welcome back to another Minecraft Bedrock tutorial with your favorite cardigan-wearing Minecraft character. And in this Minecraft Bedrock tutorial, I have for you this Nether Tree farm that's super easy to build for your Minecraft Bedrock 1.19 world. This farm can be used to produce both warped and nylium stems, and can also produce shroom lights and several other materials, including mushrooms for your Nether Tree needs. This farm has two modes of operation, a completely playerless mode that will allow you to generate as many materials as you want without any player interaction whatsoever, and a player interaction mode where you just need to AFK with an auto clicker on to place down any of the warped or crimson mushrooms. Additionally, this farm also has a built-in cube maker which will collect all of your warped and nylium stems, mushroom top leaves, and also shroom lights so that you can collect all of them using an axe later. Additionally, there are several safety features built into this, including an auto shutoff and piston push extenders that prevent this farm from breaking. In auto clicker mode, this farm is super easy to use. All you need to do is power the mechanism and push this piston. Then you can simply climb up here, and then while this is ticking and spitting out bone meal, simply auto click and place down any of your warp fungus or nylium fungus, which will spawn yourself a new tree. Push these out and push them into your cube maker. This farm produces an absolutely obscene amount of warped and crimson stems, along with shroom lights and mushrooms, all compacted here into this cube maker. It is super easy to harvest with an axe, and due to its height of being over 20 blocks tall, you are going to be collecting a lot of this material for all of your decorating needs. And remember, if you like this video and want to see more things like it, please subscribe to this video, leave a like. If you have any feedback, please feel free to leave a comment. I love hearing from you guys. So let's go ahead and get started with the tutorial. And as always, let's go ahead and start with a few of the mechanics that we are using in this farm. And there are three main mechanics that we are using. The first is this detection mechanism, very simple right here, that will allow us to detect when a block has passed over it. We have a block passed right there, as you can see, that unpowers this torch, and this will allow us to both manage our piston extenders and detect when this cube maker is full so that our pistons don't break. This is a very, very simple mechanism to break. It doesn't require a lot of explanation beyond this, but very simple to set up. Just two blocks, two torches, and then a comparator extending out of this, and this manages all of our piston extenders on this to ensure that our things don't break. The second core mechanic of this build is a very simple circuit that will basically allow us to convert a double pulse coming out of this observer into a single pulse. So as we all know, an observer will detect a block, and as you can see here, when we have that block placed in front of it, it lights this up. And depending upon the speed that you're moving at, if you are adding and removing a block very, very quickly, this can cause a double pulse, which is not good. And for this build, is not something that we want. What we want is to detect when a block updates, but only really light it up once. So to do that, we're gonna have a pulse coming out of this observer, feeding into a repeater, and then going into this repeater from one of the sides, another repeater on four ticks. And as you can see here, now when we have this, we can add and remove this block, and that redstone lamp will only light up a single time. And this is a very important circuit because it allows us to basically convert this observer, which has a double pulse, into a single pulse output. So as we can see right here, if we have the original one, maybe if we turn this actually around the correct way, we have a lamp here, add a block, see that lights up, there's kind of that double pulse that happens. And then over here, we have kind of only a single pulse happens when that's added and removed. And finally, the last component of our build is how this nether crimson and nylium roots all work. So as you can see here, when we bone meal this block, it will create a lot of different things, including this mushroom. And when we bone meal that mushroom, this will convert into a tree. Now, when a tree is spawned on top of this, sometimes this block right down here will be converted into plain old regular netherrack, which means we can't bone meal it again to get a new plant. More importantly, we cannot plant anything on top of it. However, If we have another piece of this nylium or crimson root right here, we can then bone meal this specifically if this other block ever turns into a netherrack, and that will convert this block back into the respective warp fungus or crimson fungus. So as you can see, we can't bone meal that block, but if you have a block right here beside it, you can bone meal that block, and then that will create it. Now, a couple things about this. These blocks will only spawn in mushrooms of the same color. So nylium blocks will only spawn in nylium, and crimson blocks will only spawn in crimson. So while you can use this farm for both, if you want to swap them out, you will need to swap out this block right here for the appropriate type, because otherwise you can bone meal that all that you want and it won't work. So if you see here, put this warp fungus on and then bone meal that, and now we get a tree, and wow, that is a tall tree. See, these blocks get super duper tall, and that is why this farm is so tall, because we need to harvest as much of this as we want. So with the mechanics out of the way for this farm, let's dive straight into the tutorial. To get started with this, we're going to want to mark out a 9x12 area for the tree farm alone, and then if you want to have the cube maker, you're going to need an 18x19 area as shown here. You can just make it out in this pattern as I have shown in this image, and if you are having the cube maker, you're going to have it overlap with the tree farm by one block. To get started with the tree maker, you're going to come over here on where this red line is, go over four blocks, and we're going to make a simple T-shape as shown here. You're going to grab yourself a redstone repeater, point it in this block on the right, torch on the left, and then a piece of redstone dust here at the bottom. That should start ticking on and off uncontrollably, just like that. And then you're going to want to grab yourself a lever, take that lever, place it here on the right side of the build, and then flip it off to stop that annoying ticking sound. This is going to be the main lever for our build, which is going to power everything. Next, you're going to grab yourself a sticky piston, place it right above that, and as you can see here, there is no interaction with that quite yet. Then we are going to grab ourselves a lever and place it right there so that we can control this sticky piston independently. Next, you're going to go ahead and grab yourself either your crimson or warped nylium, attach it to that sticky piston, and then place another one to the left of that as shown. Go ahead and place yourself a piece of redstone dust right there, flip that off, and then just do a quick test. And with both these levers in the up position, you should see that sticky piston extend out as shown there. Next, we're going to go ahead and place down a temporary block right down here. Grab yourself a dispenser, have it face up, and then we're going to knock out that temporary block, and then coming over here, place another temporary block on top of that dispenser, temporary block behind it, and then place a dispenser right there. So we're going to finish up the redstone circuit to power both of these dispensers. So place a block here, target block right next to this first dispenser, and we're going to add three more blocks in this L-shaped pattern. Then we're going to take out a piece of obsidian and place it directly beneath this dispenser that we have right here, and then we are going to wire this up with a redstone repeater pointing into that piece of obsidian, and then some redstone dust covering this position, and then also this block to the right of the target block. Next, just to test everything out, we're going to grab ourselves a couple pieces of bone meal, place some bone meal inside of each of these dispensers, and then you can give both these levers a flick right here. Again, you're going to need that piece of redstone dust right here, and if you have everything wired up correctly, you should see all of these nylium junk be spawned and then pop right off. Next, we're going to go ahead and create a detection circuit that will allow us to detect when a nether stem or crimson tree has grown. So we're going to place two temporary blocks here. Go ahead and pop down an observer directly on top of this with the face pointed into the farm so it can detect when a tree has grown. You're going to place that right on top of this block here. Make sure that the face and the red dot is facing out. Then you're going to go ahead and grab yourself a dropper. This needs to be a dropper, not a dispenser. Have the face pointed out, and then an observer facing down. Then you're going to go ahead and grab yourself one temporary block. Then we're going to place a temporary block right here to the right of this nylium block that we have right here. And then we're going to wire up our detection circuit that will allow us to detect when a tree has grown so that we can trigger the rest of this build. So go ahead and build out this 3x3 with the two corners knocked out, and then we're going to build that detection circuit that we built earlier. So repeater facing out towards the back, repeater on four ticks to the side, and then redstone dust wiring this all together. So thus far, this is basically all of the redstone for this. Everything else is just sticky pistons and some honey blocks and slime. So we're gonna come around here to the back and we're gonna extend out five blocks as shown here. Then we're going to grab ourselves some honey blocks and our slime blocks and some sticky pistons. And then we are going to do alternating rows of honey blocks and slime blocks going up. So on the very back here, place down that. You should have three pieces of honey and slime. And then we're gonna build up with our sticky pistons 20 blocks tall. So go ahead and place 20 blocks of the sticky pistons all the way up. Should be level with that. And then just like I said, alternating blocks of slime and honey all the way up. Make sure that these are alternating, because if they are not alternating, they will not stick correctly and then things will break very, very quickly with your farm. Once you have all of these honey blocks in place and your slime blocks in place, go ahead and build up a tower of blocks. You can use any type of block you want as long as it's movable. I'm using sandstone because I love sandstone. And then we're gonna top the sides and the back with obsidian. It is really important that you use obsidian for this, and there's a lot of obsidian. So if you need some obsidian, make sure that you go to the end, take care of the Ender Dragon, and then start mining some of those obsidian towers. Alternatively, if you simply cannot be bothered to mine this, you can alternatively use masons to get glazed terracotta. However, I recommend for the back that we're going to build of all of these towers that you use obsidian. So you can use glazed terracotta for the sides here so that nothing sticks to them, but for the backs and the bottom, you're really going to want to use obsidian, because obsidian, unlike glazed terracotta, cannot be moved. Once you have the sides all done, you're going to want to come here to the back, and then we're going to stack up obsidian. Again, this needs to be obsidian. You cannot use glazed terracotta for this. And then we're going to do alternating rows of obsidian or any other type of block that you want, just as shown here, going all the way up. We're going to do it alternating. This will allow us to power each of these pistons with the added benefit that our pistons cannot break and will not be pushed backwards. So once you have that tower reached up like here, you're going to go ahead and grab yourself a redstone repeater and then also some glass or any other type of block that you want. I'm going to use glass here. And then we're going to place glass extending out of each of these. We're going to repeat that all the way down here for each of these. Make sure you have this alternating pattern so your redstone doesn't interact. Then you're going to go ahead and place repeaters on each of these, again, in this alternating pattern. And then go ahead and place a piece of redstone dust behind it. Next, we need to go ahead and wire this up. So build out two glass blocks, build yourself a glass tower going all the way to this topmost piece of glass here. And then on each of these rows, you're just going to add a piece of glass here in a straight line. Repeat that for this side right here, and then repeat that for this side right here. And then on this other side, you can knock out that temporary piece of glass that we had placed right here. Then once all of these are built in place, then you can go ahead and line all of these pieces of glass with redstone dust. And now we have a redstone dust tower that will go all the way up this. Make sure that you get every single piece of glass. It can be a little bit difficult to see on glass, but make sure you get every single one so that our torch tower and our redstone tower works correctly. As a quick test, before you start running your farm, place a redstone torch about halfway up. You should see all 20 of these pistons extend. If you don't see a piston extend, that means that you have likely misplaced a piece of redstone dust, so just find the missing spot and then pop that in. Finally, we're going to finish this circuit off over here, so go ahead and place down a block in front of this redstone repeater, extend out, and we're going to snake this along here at the bottom. Make sure you're snaking this out like here, because if you don't, then you're gonna have a bad time with all of your mushroom blocks kind of getting in the way. Then we're gonna build up this glass tower, go about five or six levels up, so you're about halfway up. Place a repeater here connecting into that, and then connect all of this with redstone dust as shown here. Then we're going to connect that right here. And now our tree farm is basically done. Just do a quick test that if you place a block in front of that, that all of your pistons fire. If for some reason you don't, go ahead and double check your Next, to build our cube maker, we're going to want to extend out 6 blocks from behind this sticky piston. I recommend, again, that you use obsidian just because that will ensure the piston won't break. Then place down an observer just like so. We're going to place some temporary blocks right here. Then we're going to place ourselves some pistons. And again, we're going to go up 20 blocks worth of pistons. So it's worth building up an obsidian block right here. Again, for the back, I recommend you use obsidian because that will prevent things from breaking if for some reason your push limit gets extended beyond what it can handle. Then we're going to place regular pistons as shown right here, all 20 blocks high. Once that is in place, now we're going to build the same circuit to convert this into a single pulse. And then we're going to cover the sides of this also with obsidian, just so that things don't interact with it. These Nylium and Crimson trees really kind of get gnarly. So anything you don't want broken, basically just cover in obsidian. On the back of this, we're going to want to build out that alternating staircase pattern that we built before. Go ahead and alternate that as shown here on the sides. So we're going to go on the back, then on this side block right here, and then we're just going to continue all the way down. Then we're going to do the same thing with the glass that we did behind our sticky piston and honey block tower, and then fill that in with redstone and repeaters the exact same way. And when you are done building this tower over here, you should have something that looks just a little bit like this. Everything should be all nice and wired together. Then we're going to go ahead and build our double to single pulse converter circuit. It's the exact same circuit that we built on the other side here. So build yourself out a little platform, as I have shown here. You're going to have an observer pointed into dust, then into a redstone repeater. Redstone repeater on 4 ticks pointed into that repeater, and then fill in this side with dust. And then again, this is the exact same circuit that we built over here. We're just mirroring it over here. Go ahead and place yourself down a block on front of this repeater. And then we're going to build this staircase pattern going all the way up to about halfway to our tower that we have over here. And that should align very nicely with this block right here. We are then going to build this in with redstone dust and then pop a repeater in pointed to a block that we replace so that we can power all this. So redstone dust going all the way up. Go ahead and place a block here. Replace this block. Place down a redstone repeater. Dust here. Now that block can be powered. And then just as a quick test, you can go ahead and grab yourself a lever. Make sure that if you flick that, all of these go off. If for some reason you see that a block like this one right down here didn't go off, that means you probably missed a piece of redstone dust. So as you can see right down here, I missed a spot. You're going to want to make sure and test every single part of this before you get carried away with the next part, because it's so much easier to fix now than it is later. So simple fix right here, just reconnect that. Then we can test this again with a lever. And then as you can see, all of our pistons are now extended. Next, we're going to go ahead and build our cube maker, and we're going to extend out 12 blocks from our pistons, or 9 blocks from the edge of that redstone line that we have here. So you should have something that looks just a little bit like this. You can see here, that is the edge of our piston push limit. You really can't push any farther, and I don't recommend that you hit the piston push limit, because if you do, things get weird. So go ahead and extend out just 9 blocks from the edge of that. And then over here, we're going to make our detection circuit that will allow us to detect when this has reached our push limit. So place a block here, redstone torch there. Then we're going to place a comparator pointed out of that block. Then we're going to place another piece of block there. Behind this row that we built, go ahead and place yourself down some obsidian. Again, use obsidian so that things don't break, and then place pistons down and you can knock out that temporary row that we built. We're going to build up 20 levels once again of pistons. So make sure you have plenty of cobblestone and wood on hand. And we again building this all the way up to 20 levels tall, because that's the maximum amount that this particular farm is going to be able to handle. Once you have all of those pistons in place, you're going to want to make alternating rows of obsidian and just have those go up the back of this giant piston wall that you've created. Again, use obsidian here because it will help prevent your farm from breaking if the nylium mushrooms or anything else goes into it, and will also prevent the pistons from being pushed backwards. Go ahead and extend out two pieces of glass block from this obsidian line that you have created right here. And then we're going to go ahead and grab ourselves our repeaters. Place a repeater on this rightmost piece of glass block on each of these layers that we have. And then you're going to go ahead and grab yourself a piece of redstone dust on the right, and then redstone dust across all of these pieces of obsidian that we have right here. Once all of that redstone dust is in place, then all we need to do over here is build up another piece of glass tower, and then we're going to build alternating rows as shown here of redstone dust to wire everything together. So just knock out that middle block right there and you should see this glass scaffolding. Next, we need to come over here and we're going to connect this to the middle. So place down a single torch here. Make sure that you have that off for the time being, just for testing. Block, torch, block, torch, and then we're going to place another block on top of that with the torch to the side. Go ahead and place down a block here and then a repeater, and as you can see here, when we press that, that'll all push out, and that serves as a very simple test. If you want to double check any of your work, just go ahead and place a lever on any one of these blocks and you can test that all of these pistons push out. And then finally, you can go ahead and knock that temporary piston out, and then we're going to want to build out our detection circuit that will stop and shut down our farm if we reach our push limit. So go ahead and extend out a line of blocks all the way to the border block that we have here, and then we're going to extend this over directly to where this piston block is over here. So you can delete all of these temporary blocks once you've measured that out. You're going to want to place a torch and a block just as shown there, a comparator facing out, make sure that you have that comparator feeded into a block, torch here, and then we're going to build down a small staircase. So two blocks up, one block down, have a line going down into a repeater, block, and then we're going to invert that signal and then run a redstone line all the way into this repeater facing into that block. And then you can delete this temporary block, and now our farm is unlocked. So that is our locking mechanism. That is how we shut everything down. As you can see, that farm's ticking. You place a block here, this whole farm shuts off, and that acts as a safety mechanism to prevent you from basically breaking the farm. And with that, our farm and our cube maker are now completed. I recommend that before you run this for the first time, just double check all of your pistons are correctly powered or in place. This would be a terrible time for you to discover that something is broken, because these crimson and nylium stems get humongous, and trying to clear them out in survival is a massive pain. But once you have triple checked everything, you can come over here, flick this bottom lever. If you want things kind of in a manual mode where you just click, just set an auto clicker right here, that should power that. Then you can just add yourselves your crimson or nylium mushrooms. You can see right here, this will create a tree, it will push that tree out, and then once you reach the push limit where our pistons is, as you saw right there, that pushed that out to the side, and as we keep going, you should see that start to build out. Now, you're going to want to make sure that after you have tested this, that you fill both of these dispensers up with bone meal. These are going to consume a lot of bone meal, so if you need a bone meal farm, I'll have a link for one down in my description. It generates a bazillion pieces of bone meal an hour. It is obscenely fast. But if you want a very simple solution for refilling this, you can just extend out a hopper line and then pop down a barrel, or if you have shulker boxes that you're transporting your bone meal in, just go ahead and fill that up. This is a very simple solution because getting behind this farm can be a little tedious at times. So just go ahead and fill this up with as much bone meal as you want, because that will last you a very long time. Additionally, you're going to want to fill up this dispenser right up here with bone meal. Sorry, there's no way for you to really make this one filled up kind of in an automatic way. So just come up here and manually fill it up. This one won't use nearly as much bone meal as the bottom one, but this bottom one right here, yeah, this will use a lot. So make sure that you have plenty of bone meal stocked up before you run this farm. And then finally, once you've tested this, just make sure that you have items coming over here. You should see that all of these stems are extended out and being pushed out by this piston line right here. And if you've done that, you've basically confirmed that your farm is fully working. You can, if you want, place a row of obsidian right here. However, I don't really recommend it just because it might break something in the future. But if you notice that things are going past this, then you can add a piece of obsidian here and that will basically break the push limit. If you want to test this component right down here, you can go ahead and fill these up with some temporary blocks that will extend all the way over. And then once you reach that end right there, you should see that you have another row knocked out right here. Again, I recommend that you test this before you start building a bunch of trees, because having your cube maker break when you have this full of trees is a lot harder to clean up than when it just has that bottom row. A quick reminder for using this farm: if you want crimson trees, you have to have down this piece of crimson block right here, and then also replace the other one down in the bottom right. Then you can place down your crimson mushrooms and that will produce these crimson trees. And then if you want nylium, make sure you swap these back out for nylium. Alternatively, you can just build a second copy of this farm so you have one farm dedicated to nylium and another farm dedicated to crimson. So there is your crimson and nylium tree farm with a built-in cube maker for easing harvesting, all finished and done. If you like this video, please consider leaving a like. If you want to see more, consider subscribing. And if you have any questions, leave a comment down below, because you know I love hearing from you. But that's going to be it for me in this episode. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Goodbye.